infantry form the core of the Astra Militarum, and if you're painting an army from Cadia, you're probably going to be painting a lot of shock troops. Now in this video, I'm going to show you how to paint one, and also give you some tips on how to paint a unit quickly. I usually find it's best to start with the largest area of colour on a miniature, and in the case of these guys, that's going to be their fatigues, which is a khaki colour. And the colour I'm going to pick for it is Zandri Dust, and it's a good colour for this because it's a base paint, and as always, give it a good shake before you use it. And the brush I'm going to use is a large brush, and well, this stage is very straightforward. All you got to do is load your brush up with some paint, and then pop it on a palette like this. And then I like to thin it down with just a little bit of water. You don't need very much, just touch the brush just to the surface of the water, then mix it in like that. And this will help the paint flow from the brush easily and give a nice smooth coat. So it's just a simple case of, finding some of the fatigues and popping the paint on like this. Now at this stage, you don't have to be very neat. It's just a case of getting all of those fatigues this color. And you want a good smooth coat of it, so you might find you need two coats. Always remember that multiple thin coats is better than one thick coat. Now I'm going to carry on with this model and completely coat him like this. But once this is done, I'm going to move on to the next miniature, and then once he's done, onto the next one and so on. And in this way, I'll be creating a kind of production line. And I find that this is the quickest and most efficient way of painting a squad of miniatures. Cool, so there we go. I've finished painting Zandri Dust on all of his fatigues. And I've done the same on the other 9 members of the squad. So now we're ready to move on to the next stage. And the next main colour on him is his armour. So that's going to be Castellan Green. And for this, I'm going to be switching my brush to a standard brush, because this stage is a little bit more detailed. And it's just a case of, well, just like before, loading up your brush and popping some paint on the palette like that. And once again, I'm going to thin it down with just a tiny bit of water. So there we go. And a good trick to learn here is when you're painting something with more detail, just twist your brush and drag it like that, and you'll get rid of any excess paint. And this will give you a nice fine tip on your brush. And that makes it very easy to control and be neat on what you're doing. So it's just a case of painting this onto all of his armor. So just like this. And you can see here the beauty of the base paints in that they cover up other colors really easily. So you know how I was really messy with all that Zandri dust? It doesn't matter at all now, because every time I put on a new base colour, I'll be neatening it up as I go. So there we go. I've finished applying the Castellan Green to this trooper, and, well, I've also finished on all the other men as well. And we're ready now for the next stage, which is another base colour. This time it's a Baden Black. And the brushes I'm going to be using are a standard, and I've also got a detail on hand as well, just in case there's any particularly fiddly bits in the model. And it's the same application process as before. So I'm just going to get some paint and pop it on the palette and thin it with a little bit of water. And use that trick of twisting my brush again just to get a good fine tip on it, because the areas I'm looking for now are fairly detailed. I'm looking for things like his belt, for example. Any areas that you want to be black, now's the time to paint those in. So there we go, with the black done, we're now ready to move on to the next step, and that is to paint the skin. Now the colour I'm going to use for this is Bugman's Glow, and the brushes are, well, the same two as before, a standard brush and a detail brush. Now the standard brush is going to be for painting the hands, but the detail brush, that's for doing the face, and that's because, well, it'll be a little bit fiddly, so you need to be neat with that. So same process as normal. I've got my detail brush here for doing the face. I'm going to thin the paint down with just a little bit of water, and then use that twisting trick to get rid of any excess paint. So I've got a nice fine tip on the brush. So it's just a case of carefully prodding the paint into the face like that. So be as neat as you can. Don't worry if you make any mistakes. Just get a good base coat like this. And then once you've done the face, do the same process for the hands. So there we go. I've finished base coating the flesh and now we're ready to move on. Now it's at this stage that you should check through your models and just make sure there are no mistakes or anything, because the next part is to put a shade across the whole model. So now's the time to fix any mistakes if you've made any. The colour I'm going to use is Agrax Earthshade, and I'm going to be using a wash brush. And, well, this part's very easy. All you've got to do is load your brush up with plenty of wash and pop some on your palette like this. This will just help you control how much you've got on your brush. And all you've got to do is paint it all over your miniature. So just slap it on like this, keep moving it around and cover the whole model. And you can see immediately, this is giving us some really good shading on those fatigues just there, and on the armor too. Now, this will take a little while to dry, so I recommend you leave the model for about an hour, just to be sure. But, well, I'm just going to go through the whole squad now and do this on all of them. Now the shade has dried, well, it's added loads of depth to the model, especially on the fabric, and it's starting to look really good. But the next stage is to carry on doing some more base colours, because now we've done all the ones that used Angrax Earthshade to shade them. Now we're going to be doing all the ones that use Norn Oil. So the first of those is going to be silver, and the colour I'm using is Lead Belcher. And the brushes are going to be the standard and the detail brush again. And like before, I'm going to be jumping back and forth between these, depending on what detail I'm painting. So just as always, get a bit of paint on your brush and pop it on the palette. And I'm going to thin it with just a little bit of water. There we go. And then get rid of any excess paint by twisting my brush. And I'm just looking for, well, all the details that are going to be silver. So the bayonet blade, of course, is going to be silver. And some bits around here. And the muzzle of the gun's silver too. And so there's all sorts of little details. Things like the water canteen and any like grenades or anything like that. The belt buckle as well. It's just a case of working around the model and picking them all out. And with the Lead Belcher done, there's just one more base colour to do before we move on to the Norn Oil, and that's Celestra Grey. Now, this is for all the winged emblems that appear on him. So there's a winged skull on the gun, for example, and there's a little eagle on his chest as well. And the brush I'm going to use is a detail brush, because this is quite fine and fiddly work, this. So I've got this emblem on the side of his gun here. It's just a case of base coating it with this colour. There we go, now we're ready to apply the Norn Oil. Now, this is going to be a bit different to the shade we used earlier when we were painting Angrax Earthshade on the model, because I'm going to be using a standard brush, and that's because I'm going to be applying it quite carefully. So, usual process of putting some on the palette, but I want to be careful that I don't have loads and loads on the brush. And what I'm going to be doing is painting it on like this. So, you see, it's very different to what I was doing with the Angrax Earthshade. I'm being much neater here. So I'm looking for all the areas that are painted Celestra Grey and Lead Belcher. I've finished applying all the base colours and the shades now, but, well, the model's now quite dark, so the next thing I need to do is go back to those initial two colours that I used, so Zandri Dust and Castellan Green, and I'm going to apply them again, but this time in the manner of a layer paint. So the first one I'll do is Zandri Dust, and the brush I want is a standard brush. And it's important here that you get good control over the paint. So I'm going to pop it onto the palette and get that nice pointed tip on the brush. There we go. And now what I'm looking to do on the model, on his fatigues, is look for all the creases and paint this on it again, but only on the raised areas like this. So I'm leaving that darker colour showing in all those recesses, just like that. And once you finish the Zandri Dust, we're going to be doing exactly the same thing, but this time on the Castellan Green areas. So I'm still using the standard brush, and as before, I've got to be neat on this, but it's just a case of painting these armour panels and leaving that darker green showing in the recesses. Now I've finished painting on the Zandri Dust and the Castellan Green, you can see they've really enriched those colours. And the next stage is to add some highlights to the model. Now I'm going to be adding four before finally moving on to the flesh. The first one on the khaki areas is a Shabti Bone. On the green areas is Lauren Forest. On the silver areas is Runefang Steel. On the pale grey areas is Althuan Grey. Now I'm going to be starting out with a Shabti Bone to show you exactly what to do. The brush you need is a detail brush, because this is, well, it's quite fine work. And it's very important that you get that good fine tip on your brush. It's also important that the paint flows freely from the brush, so be sure you water it down a little bit. So there we go. Now, what I'm looking for on the model are any raised bits of detail, like the creases on his trousers here. And all I'm going to do is paint a thin line along them like that. And doing this really helps bring out that shape of all the detail. So it's just a case now of working around all these fatigues, painting on lines like this. Now, it is, as I say, quite fiddly work doing this, so you might find it's tricky to keep a steady hand whilst you're doing it. If that's the case, then something I find helpful is to brace your hands right down on the table like that, and that really can help out. But what I'm going to do now is carry on painting this on all the khaki areas, and then we'll be ready for the next highlight. And with the Ashabti bone done, the next colour is Lauren Forest, and this time you're looking for the armour plates. So it's a very similar process to before. Get a nice fine tip in your brush, and you want to go around the edges of all of them, on all sharp edges like this bit on the helmet just here, painting a thin line on all the corners like this. And then it's exactly the same process on all the silver bits with Runefang steel. And once again, I'm using the detail brush because it's very important here that I keep that nice fine tip on it. And the final of the four highlights is Orthoan Grey, which I'm going to be painting onto all of these light grey areas. And once again, I'm using the detail brush so that I can get a nice fine tip on it. Now, a good trick you can do here is, first of all, make sure you don't have very much paint on your brush, like I've got here. And instead of using the tip on these wings, use the side of it instead, like this, because then the brush will only catch those raised areas and pick out the shape for you. So I've finished most of the highlights now, and there's just one more main area to paint, and that's the skin. And for doing this, you're going to need two colours. The first is Cadian Flesh Tone, and the second is Kislev Flesh. And the brush I'm going to be using for both of these is a detail brush. And what's most important is that you get a good fine tip on your brush here, because this is going to be quite detailed work. So I'm just going to be using my palette to thin down the paint a little bit with some water, and also make sure I've got that good fine tip on the brush. So on the face, the areas you're looking to paint are all the raised surfaces. So things like the nose, for example, the bridge of his nose, just like that. And there's also his cheeks, just there. And that one. And around his mouth, just the top of his lip there. And also his bottom lip, like that. Then also, there's just a bit of his brow showing beneath the helmet, just there. And there we go. So that's really all you need to do for the face at this stage. There's also the hands too. And a good trick to do is to use the side of your brush again on the fingers and paint them like that. That way, you can avoid getting any paint in between the fingers, and you get that nice bit of shading showing through. I've finished the Cadian Flesh Tone, and I think the model's looking really good. I mean, I could leave the skin here, but I find that the face is a real focal point to the model, so I like to go just a little bit further with it. So I've got some Kislev Flesh, and still using my detail brush. And what I'm going to do is very carefully paint just a bit of it on the bridge of the nose, like that, and also just a little bit on top of the cheeks. So just a bit there, and on the other side, just a bit there. There we go, and doing this just really brings out the shape of the face. Now it's a good idea to do it on the hands as well, and what I like to do is paint lines going down the hand, just up to the knuckle, just like that. There we go, so I'm going to do this on the other hand, and all the rest of the squad as well. And after that, well, all that's left is to base the model. So I'm going to base it in the same way as the rest of my army, and I recommend you do the same. So there we go, I've finished painting my infantryman, and well, I think he's looking great. But even more than that, I think the whole squad's looking brilliant. I'm really happy with how they've come out, and they've been nice and quick to paint too. So when you're painting unit like Cadians, remember it's a good idea to set up a kind of production line, because you'll find that this is a very efficient way of painting a whole unit. Now there was quite a lot of detail on these models, so it's always a good idea to get a nice fine tip on your brush. So remember that twisting technique that I use on the palette. And finally, the face is a real focal point on miniatures like this, so it pays to spend extra time and care on that part, because it will really lift the whole miniature if you do.